Hi, it's Alaska Granny. When I was down in Arizona, I picked up a little magazine and it had an article about keeping the pantry full, which I thought, isn't that nice? They're telling everyone to be prepared. But they're saying, no, help keep the food pantries for the needy full, which I thought, well, that's well and good too, but everybody needs to be stocking up on their own. And then I read an alarming statistic in here that said that 2 million families in Arizona are dependent on just this one food bank network. And that's not all of the food banks in Arizona. And it also said that in 1 year's time, they went from 30,000 boxes of food a month to 40,000 boxes of food a month in 1 year. That is a 25% increase over people who are expecting someone else to help keep their family fed. And that's over 1 year's time. If you continue to see people dependent on emergency food at such an alarming rate, and that is beyond food stamps, beyond school lunches, all of that, there are a lot of people that don't have enough to eat. Take this as a wake-up call and make sure you are providing your family with a bountiful abundance in your pantry, because there's a whole lot of people in line ahead of you if something happens and you run out of food. So I thought it was interesting that they said they wanted peanut butter, canned tuna, and soup. So I thought, well, I'm going to make sure I have plenty of that too. Well, it's all well and good to donate and help others, you number one need to make sure you are providing for your family. And I have been reading all kinds of things lately that are giving me a tremendous wake-up call to ensure that I'm providing for my family. And I'm going to start $15 a week. I'm going to start, or every time I go to the market, I'm going to spend an extra $15 just on stocking my pantry. If you don't have 3 to 6 months worth of food in your pantry, things that you can just go and eat, canned food, dry food, things like that. I'm not talking about MREs or gigantic buckets, because none of us want to go drag out a bucket of beans and start cooking for our family next week. But you might want to open up some cans of chili or boxes of noodles and make some spaghetti. Start making sure that you have enough for your family. Stockpile the things that you can make a meal with. Make up recipes of things that you already like, and then buy extras of those items to ensure that you have enough for your family. Here's what I bought for $15 on this trip to the market. I found Chef Boyardee raviolis, 3 different flavors, for $1 each, so I bought 10. I also bought 2 jars of peanut butter. I don't ever buy the gigantic ones because I don't want it to get rancid before somebody gets to the bottom of it. Plus, it's easy to grab and go, a smaller size container. You can stick one in your bug out bag. You can stick one in your picnic bag. You can stick it in your purse if you need to, or throw one in your suitcase. Small size things are easier for my family to deal with. I don't have 10 children. Get started on your food storage. Make sure that you have 3 to 6 months of canned or like packaged foods right in your pantry. Things that you could eat on an everyday normal basis to keep your family going. Make this a wake-up call. Make it a priority. You never want to see your family going without. Let me know what you're doing for your food storage. Please subscribe to the Alaska Granny channel and have a wonderful day.